This is the story about the Cofan people and one of their villages called Zábalo. This village is located in the northeastern part of Ecuador along the Agua Rica River. This video will introduce you to the people and the culture of the Cofan. In 1954, American missionaries traveled to Dorino to analyze the language of Ayinge linguistically so that they could develop an alphabet, teach basic reading and writing skills, and translate the Bible into the language. Randy Borman, only 1 year old at the time, was raised in Dorino and later became the tribal leader of all 13 communities. He is bicultural and trilingual. He is the Western spokesperson for the Cofan.
Cofan people as a whole, in her history in the Inca times, actually, as one of the groups that was living along the side of the Andes, stretching out into the tropical rainforest in this whole region. Pretty much the same region, and as far as we know, all of the clues suggest that it was part of a larger language group that was all through northern Ecuador, and that were badly impacted by the Incas, the Inca invasions, and then of course the Spanish invasions right after that. We follow them through history, and during the colonial times, because they were the main people living out in this area, they were considered a group that was difficult to work with, had their own customs, their own way of living and everything. But large populations that both the Incas and the Spanish talk about were decimated by the diseases, to the point where when my parents came in as missionaries in the 1950s, the group had been reduced to probably, it was just down to really, really survival limits. There were probably only 400, 500 Cofans left in the world, Cofan speakers. Kind of floating around in a great big vacuum of the Agua Rica and the San Miguel to the north of the Pico. Hunting and fishing, 20th century lifestyle was just very, very, very simple. Small villages, maybe 70 or 80 people in a village. Zábalo presently numbers about 150. But, you know, the basic format was just hunting and fishing and subsistence agriculture and kind of floating around, and people who are very, very independent, very socially interlinked with each other, and constant visiting and talking, very friendly, very open people.
Isn't that amazing? So I'm going to give this to one of your sons to take with you this afternoon. Because are they going to help you with finding the cypress tree and everything? Yeah.
Despertar y bajar de esta estrella fugaz que en su luz. 哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈
The Cofan are sensitive to nurturing, very hands-on and artistic. They are individualistic learners, but learn well in groups. All individuals are equal as long as they provide a useful service to the community. Elders take youths into the jungle to demonstrate and experience things firsthand. They are shown countless times until the children eventually learn the material. The men are the social outward people of the tribe.
In the kitchen again.
Nasrina, what's that? What's that?
What's
that? What's that? What's that?
What's that? What's